desk. Not to just update the status on Willie and Trey, everything 100% of them and how they've been doing.
Trey's probably about 90-some percent. Willie's healthy and able to go. Trey's still, you know, a little more speed and lift and him trusting his leg a little bit, but he's fine.
Now, you're not used to having juniors around here. How can Willie and Alex change since the captain?
Well, you'd say that, but I had Darius and I had Josh and I've had upperclassmen, but they've done well. And the greatest thing is they're on a team that pushes them as they push the team. There's not going to be anything easy about it, and they know that, so they've responded pretty good.
Along those lines, what have your practices been?
Have your practices been what you would expect from a team that's got, you know, 12 starter caliber guys as compared to maybe 2 years ago when you had walk-ons going on in practice?
Yeah, the practices should be what they are, which is they're competitive, and there's no easy baskets. You're not getting layups. But we've got a lot of learning to do, and we're still, I'm not convinced of what the groups will look like. Yesterday or 2 days ago, I changed the groups a little bit, and I didn't like them, and I went back. We may change some big guys and switch them on different teams to see what that looks like. Because at the end of the day, I'm coaching two teams. All my mentors that are the older coaches, Jack Lehman, Joe B. Hall, Gene Bartow, even Coach John Wooden, when he talked to me saying the best teams they coached, they played six guys. Maybe a seven, but it was more like six. The best teams that I've coached six guys, whether it's Mass, Memphis, or here. Now, that being said, so I'm doing it twice now. In other words, I'm coaching these guys together, and I'm coaching two different teams. And I've asked to be paid twice. I'm not sure they'll do that, but if I've got to coach two teams, then I think it's fair. Question anyway.
Good. You've only got so much time. Now you're doing, just to go along with your theme, two teams instead of one. How does that hurt your time? How does that?
The issue becomes they need to compete against each other because we got to figure out, are these the groups we like? But in the same sense, you can't skip steps and you can't go buy things that don't really need. There are probably, I would tell you, things that to score against this team, because this team is very long, you have to beat us in transition. So obviously we're working on that. Down in the Bahamas, it was probably one of our weak areas. The second thing you're going to have to do is shoot a lot of threes, because you're just not going to get anything next to the rim. So we're spending more time than I have in the past how to guard the three line and also knock down three shooters that were playing them a little different than I have in the past. And then the other, you know, non-negotiables are diving for the balls, loose balls, and the other would be sprinting the court. If you don't sprint the court, it's an absolute, you will sprint. If you don't, you come out. So those are kind of things we're working on right now.
John, once we do see Trey, what type of player are we going to see?
The biggest thing that we saw with him is he's got some of that dog in him, like he's bringing it. Like, if you came at him, he's not moving. So when you come at him the next time, he's in the same place. And when he comes at you, he's coming at you, and you're going to know he came at you. The biggest thing, though, is his skill set. He's a smooth player who can shoot, and he's 6'10". So playing him at the three is not like people say, you can't play. No, if you watch, he can easily play the position. Now, guarding the position, maybe he guards the four and Willie guards the three. Or he guards the four and Marcus Lee guards the three. We're just trying to figure all that out.
Coach, how do you coach Andrew and Harrison differently from last year since their sophomores now?
Well, they came in with a 16% body fat. They're down to four. The thing that the feedback from the combine about those two were weak men, their speed and athleticism, their bodies look great, they're better skilled. So everybody knows they've gotten better. And again, trying to get those guys to play the way this team needs them to play, which is what they're starting to do, that's going to be the key to this.